our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters and brothers in Christ, once anew this morning we are here to celebrate this great mystery, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this mystery, the worthy man who has called to abide in our families. I confess
that to our Lord.
Knowing good and evil.
now lest he put forth his hand and take also the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore the Lord God sent him forth from the garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. He drove out the man, and at the east of the garden of Eden he placed a cherubim and a flaming sword which turned every way to guard the way to the tree of life. The word of God. Our response is, O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. Can I repeat? O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. Before the mountains were born, or the earth or the world brought forth, you are God without beginning or end. Our response, O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation. You turn men back into dust and say, Go back, sons of men. To your eyes a thousand years are like yesterday. Come and go, no more than a watch in the night. A response, O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. You sweep men away like a dream, like grass that springs up in the morning. In the morning it springs up and flowers. By evening, it withers and fades. Our response, O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. Make us know the shortness of our life, that we may gain wisdom of might. Lord, relent. Is your anger forever? Show pity to your servants. Our response, O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation.
Of the one who
The Gospel of the Lord. Our God is compassionate and love. He's full of compassion and love. That's what we see in the both the readings today. The entire salvation history is been narrated in today's first reading. Man, a human being, sin, and because of the sin, the relationship between God and man was broken. And this relationship was broken, and in this relationship, God takes an initiative to build up that broken relationship. That's why He goes in search of love. He goes in search of the one who is lost. He goes and in search of the one who is far away from Him. And He wants to bring them back to Him because He has created them in His own image and likeness. That's why He doesn't want that anybody should be lost. That's why He goes in search of the soul which is far away from Him. That's what we find same characteristics in the person of Jesus too. Because Jesus is also a God. He goes in search of the lost sheep. Even He leaves the 99 and goes and searches the one who is lost. He is like a father, merciful father, waiting for His prodigal son to come back. And when he does back, he runs ahead to meet his son. That is what our God is. Full of compassion, full of mercy, full of love. My dear brothers and sisters, Adam and Eve realized their mistake. They understood when Lord asked, "Where are you?" Only one sentence, "Where are you?" And Adam and Eve realized where they were. They realized that they had committed blunder in their life. They realized their sin. They realized that they have broken commandment. They realized that they had broken the covenant which the Lord had given them. They realized. And because they realized, God took another step. "No worry, I am merciful." And He clothed them with His mercy. That's what our God wants from us. That we should realize ourselves, where are we? Where are we heading towards? What is our state of life? Unless we realize, God will not do anything for us. God will take many steps for us to search for us. He will put many situations that we may realize our own mistakes, that we may realize where are we. Once we realize, it's our duty to turn back to God, to seek His mercy. In the Old Testament, God forbid them that they should reach their hand to the tree of life. In the New Testament, God has opened the gates, God has opened the tree of life for us, because Jesus is the one who died on the cross. And when He died on the cross, the tree of life was opened to us. Now each one of us has to go to the tree of life and eat from it, that we may have life, life eternal. And He gives us the opportunity to eat from it in our daily Eucharist. The same bread, the flesh of Jesus, comes on this altar, that we may eat it and that we may live forever, eternally with the Father, that we may enjoy His company. It is each one of us has to come to the tree of life, take it and eat it. May Lord help us to realize where we are, and that we may approach the sacrament of confession, that we may build up our broken relationship. May Lord help us.
sisters and brothers, that this offering of ours will be acceptable to God, your Almighty Father. We offer you the sacrifice of praise, O Lord, as we rejoice in commemorating the mother of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may advance towards eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived the only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with the others in humble praise as we acclaim. Joseph was, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, be We demand to be wise to eternal life and to praise and glorify you through our Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.